श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतम करुणामयम् नमामि चिन्मयम् देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मवित्वरम्। ओम सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। द लास्ट मंत्र वी स्टडीड वाज द 16th वन। घृतात् परम मंडमिवाति सूक्ष्मम् ज्ञात्वा शिवं सर्वभूतेषु गूढं विश्वस्यैकं परिवेष्टितारं ज्ञात्वा देवं उच्यते सर्वपाशैः। ज्ञात्वा देवं, रियलाइजिंग दिस गॉड, दिस ट्रूथ अलोन, द पर्सन इज फ्रीड फ्रॉम ऑल द मृत्युपाश। नाउ लेट अस सी अगेन दिस नेक्स्ट मंत्र, मोर ऑर लेस वी हैव सीन अर्लियर ऑल्सो। एष देवो विश्वकर्मा महात्मा, सदा जनानां हृदये सन्निविष्टः, हृदा मनीषा मनसा विकृप्तो, य एतद्विदुर अमृतास्ते भवन्ति। एष देवः, दिस गॉड, विच गॉड, अबाउट हुम वी हैव बीन कंटिन्यूअसली सीइंग, एटलीस्ट ऑनलाइन, यू नो आई एम टोल्ड ऑन गॉड मैक्सिमम इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल। इफ यू सर्च गूगल एंड ऑनलाइन एनी पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक विच हैज गॉट मैक्सिमम एंट्रीज एंड इंफॉर्मेशन इज गॉड। And one day God also saw that and he said, my God, I also did not know so much about myself. Esha Devaha, this God, about him libraries and libraries are also full, and so many people have come and spoken about that. In this Upanishad also we have talked. So there is a lot about God, but only some rare one knows God. That's what the peculiar thing is. It is said a lot of about. But do you know, Tulsidas ji says, so janahi jehi dehu janahi. जानत तुम ही हो जाए। ट्रूली ओनली दैट पर्सन हुम गॉड रिवील्स हिज ओन नेचर, दैट पर्सन ट्रूली एंड कंप्लीटली नोज। अदर्स यू नो वी नो अ लॉट अबाउट दैट, एंड दैट इंस्पिरेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कंटिन्यू आवर स्टडी, आवर साधना। बट डू नॉट थिंक ओनली बाय दी स्टडीज and lot of discussions alone we can realize God, but we should keep on invoking God's grace. So whether you call it God's grace, Guru's grace, but when the grace and our efforts they come together, then we realize what really that God is. And when that happens, we'll come to know that whatever we understood earlier was we don't know what to call that, but it was too precious little, you know, very very little that what we understood. But the God is Tripadascha Amritam Divi. So what we come to know is just little about his glories only, but what God is wo to God hi bata sakte hain. Esh Devo Vishwakarma Vishwakarma, the creator of the entire universe. Now someone may say, right from the beginning you are telling the creator of this world, creator of this world, and tell something new, you know. But do you know, Vajesa, creator of this world, but how many kinds of worlds are there? Do you have got any idea about them? Only if you think about the creation, there are a number of creations that come into being in different ways. One is only sankalpa srishti. In the beginning, Bhagavan does only sankalpa, and only by thought alone the creation comes into being. Chakshisha srishti also is there. Just Bhagavan looks, and by his look only things can be created. Only shabda, only speak, and that srishti can be there. So shabda srishti, chitra srishti, chakshu srishti, kasankalpa srishti. And then the male and female coming together, this is the grossest form of this creation that what we talk about. But there are so many creations are there, you know. So if you study in the Bhagavatam also, there you will find, so bhuta srishti, indriya srishti, prani srishti, there are a variety of creations there. So when it is said again and again, so what it means, that any kind of creation that anyone can think about, Bhagavan alone is the creator of that. Then there are artists are there, painters are there, writers are there, poets are there, and musicians are there. Dancers are there, they also create their all kinds of srishti, and the scientists are there. But who is the one who is giving them that buddhi? Just think of it. So then when we talk of the creation, it's not one kind of, there are countless. Esha Devo Vishwakarma Mahatma, the great soul. Because Atma is Mahan only. Mahan Atma. And other day I told you Mahan Atma means the one who is not narrow-minded, the large-hearted, that Mahatma. Next line is beautiful. Sada Jananam Hridaye Sannivishta. Sada, always Jananam Hridaye, in the hearts of all beings, Sannivishta, existing, living. You know what a beautiful thing is that? See, if you have to go and meet some person, first of all, you have to make sure whether that person is there or not. And you have to take that appointment also. Sometimes a person is there, but he may not give appointment. But we have to see whether that, even if you go to a temple, you have to find out what are the opening and closing time of the temple. Even though God is sitting there, but the executive committee only decides the timing of the temple. But one very beautiful thing about this Paramatma, it is in my heart. Sada, that Sada word is very weird. Sada jana naam hridaye sannivishta. So any time you can just contact it. Don't have to take anybody's permission, anybody's what you call appointment, and nothing. Night 2 o'clock you got up suddenly. You woke up and all that. And then you wanted to meet Bhagavan. Sit down there. How nice it is that Sada, always, always available. It is in your own heart only. Moko kahan dhunde bande, main to tere paas. Where are you searching? Where are you searching? But I am so close to you. So close that I am you. Even if you say close to you, also is taking me far only. So this, I love this line. Sada jana naam hridaye sannivishta. So any time you can just say. Hrida manisha manasa vikrupto. But what a strange thing is there. Even in our own heart, it is now hidden. Manasabhi krupto hrida, that also we have seen earlier. Because of various kinds of emotions, feelings and thoughts, and various kinds of concepts and imaginations and extrovertedness, all those things are hiding, even though it is there only. So we are only hiding it. Earlier it was Rida Manvisha, here it is now Manisha. Rida Manisha Manasabhikrupta. So it is now hidden under many, many concepts and feelings and emotions and all that. And our feelings are also so wonderful. I am hurt. Every now and then I am hurt. You hurt my feelings. And the other man says, oh, you have feelings also? I never knew that. And then you get more. See, you are hurting me more. So the vichara atma, we don't see it only because all the time we are with this only. We have got our own views, our opinions and ideas, and somebody does not agree with us, we get angry. But every time everybody should agree with me, you know. But one man was very wise man. He said, I get along with everybody easily without any problem. I said, how do you do that? He said, I agree with everybody. So then there is no problem at all. If somebody says it is daytime, I said yes. If somebody says it is night, yes. Whatever you say, that's right. So he has no problem at all. क्या समझे तो मनसा भी उपयुक्त हाँ अदरवाइज वी हैव गॉट अवर ओन सो मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट एंड इवन दो दैट्स हृदय सदा जना विल बी नॉट सीन बट य एतद् विदुः अमृतास्ते भवन्ति बट दोज हु नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट इज देयर इन माई हार्ट एनी टाइम आई जस्ट लुक विद इन एंड इट इज देयर दैट इज मी हाँ Why unnecessarily imagine this and that and all that? So they become fearless, they become immortal, and that's what it is. This non-dual, this Paramatma defies all our concepts and thoughts and all that. Yada tamatastanna divanaratrihi. न सन्न चासि शिव एव केवलः तदक्षरं तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं प्रज्ञा च तस्मात् प्रसृता पुराणी नाउ हियर इज दिस परमात्मा हाउ इज दैट इट इज ऑलवेज देयर एंड We cannot say it is this, it is that, it is not this. That's what it is. Yada when it is or yat. Yada atamaha. Tamaha means darkness. When there is no darkness. Oh, there is no darkness means there must be daylight. Nadiva. There is no daytime also. Oh, must be ratri. Na ratri. No. Oh. This Paramatma, and there is no darkness, and there is neither day nor night, na sat, na asat. There is neither sat, there is not nor asat. Then what? Shiva eva kevalam, kevala. When there was absolutely nothing, and then this Paramatma, Neither sat nor asat. What is this sat? No light, no darkness, no day, no night. You know, in the Upanishad it is said, Sadeva somya idam agra asit. Ekameva advitiyam. One alone without a second. That truth alone was there. That's called kevala. Sadeva somaya idamagri. Nanyat kinchana vishat. Nothing else winked. Nothing else moved. केवल शिव है. यू नो इफ यू रीड सम भाष्य भगवान शंकराचार्य वेरी ब्यूटिफुली सेज, यू से फर्स्ट ही गिव्स एग्जांपल लाइक गोल्ड इज देयर एंड फ्रॉम गोल्ड ऑल ऑर्नामेंट्स आर क्रिएटेड, बट बिफोर ऑर्नामेंट्स आर क्रिएटेड देर वे नो ऑर्नामेंट्स, सो देर वे नो फॉर्म्स एंड देर वे नो नेम्स ऑल्सो, राइट. बट ही सेज समवन वॉज देयर टू से दैट देर इज दिस गोल्ड एंड the names and forms, even though they were not manifest, but they were in unmanifest forms are there. So this shabda pratyaya was there, word was there, and the experience of that word also was there, even though the actual thing was not there. But when we say here sadeva somya ida akura asit, that sat alone, even there was no one to say, even that sat alone was there. Who will say that? Sat is a pure existence. So there were neither shabda nor pratyaya also. That is called the absolute one that. Still we have to give some word. That is our problem. So you say Shiva eva kevala. Kevala means what? That reality which is free from, totally from all kinds of differences we can think of or know of or imagine. The differences in two different species, difference in a given species only, and difference in a given thing only. This is called vijatiya, sajatiya, swagat ved. All Vedas, no Vedas, that's called Keval. Now here the Shiva word also is not used in the meaning of what called Shiva, Shankar and like that. It is pure auspiciousness. Now neither Sat nor Asat. Now what is neither Sat nor Asat? Because Sat we call it a real, unreal. So what we call generally real is only whatever is seen by the senses we call real. And what is seen by the senses is gross. Therefore, when we say there was no sat, means there was no gross thing. And asat means something different from sat. And different from gross is subtle. And therefore, no subtle also was there. No thoughts and feelings and emotions and ideas, concepts, opinions, views, nothing was there. And the idea of existence and non-existence also, who will have that idea of existence, non-existence? What is there and what that srishti is? Nobody knows from where the srishti has come and what the srishti is. You know, there is a beautiful suktam in Rigveda called Nasadiya Suktam. There it is said, nobody knows what this creation is and from where the creation has come. Nobody knows. He says, the only one who created this world, maybe he knows, maybe he also does not know. That is said in the Vedas, you know. What if maybe he also does not know? To point out the total inexplicability of this whole thing and all. Indescribability. You can't, when it is said, even God also knows it or not, we don't know. Some of you say, only God knows. You see, he also knows it or not. When we say such a thing that he also knows it or not, what we mean only, how it is mind-boggling, and how it is, you know, indescribable and anirvachaniya indeed is this srishti. There was no darkness, there was no day, there was no night, no gross, no subtle. Kabirdaji says, amarvah deshva jahan se aayo. पानी न पवन न धरती आकाशवा नो आकाश वायु अग्नि जल पृथ्वी का चलो वही देश गो बैक यू हैव कम फ्रॉम देयर दैट ट्रूथ दिस इज यदा अतमह तन्न दिवान रात्रि न स न स च स असत् शिव एव केवल तद अक्षरम दैट इज इम्पेरिशबल तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम न तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम भर्ग दैट इज इन गायत्री मंत्र इट इज दैट तेज ऑफ सविता देवता विच इज वरेण्यम विच इज वरणीयम वॉट इज सेड देयर और इट इज ए सवितु वरेण्यम मीन इट इज समथिंग वर्शिपफुल फॉर इवन गॉड सन गॉड ऑल्सो because it is the essence of atma of sun god also savituhu varanyam and prajna cha tasmat prasuta purane and it is from that absolute truth alone the prajna the knowledge emerged out in ancient time and all that that is this paramatma in the gita say yata pravrutti prasuta purane Everything that is source, the source of all knowledge, all power, all creation, all that is this alone. It is surprising that people do not accept the existence of omniscient being and proud of their own little intelligence. You ask from where your intelligence has come? Like a glass of water, proud of that its quantity of water, and denying the existence of the ocean. What kind of notion is that? You see, what a strange thing. You say little things are that you are, and the total that power you don't accept. Ashcharyam khalu vartate. यदा तमस्तन्न दिवान रात्रि न सन्न चास शिव एव केवल तदक्षरम तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यम प्रज्ञा च तस्मात् प्रसुता पुराणी एंड दैट्स व्हाई इन द भागवतम देयर इज अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल श्लोक श्रियपतिर्यज्ञपति प्रजापति धियां पतिर्लोकपतिर्धरापति पतिर्गतिश्चांदक वृष्णि सात्वतां प्रसीदतां मे भगवान सतां पति That Paramatma, only the Lord of Shriyapatihi, Lord of Shri Lakshmi, Yadnyapati of Yadnya, Prajapatihi, Dhyampatihi is the Lord of the intellect. Do you know in Srimad Bhagavat you will find when Raja Parikshit asked so many questions to Shukdevji, the one chapter, entire chapter is only doing Namaskar to Bhagavan. Then Shukdevji begins. The whole chapter is of Namaskar only. So those who are really wise people, they understand Dhyampati. The Dhipati is Bhagwan only. And here also say Prajna, Prasuta, Yasmat. So if we recognize that and remain tuned with that Paramatma, then see the Prajna flows. The knowledge will flow. The next mantra, and particularly second line, is of most charming. I read such a line only in this Upanishad and not any other Upanishad. Naina urdhvam na tiryancha na madhye parijagrabhat na tasya pratima asti yasya naam mahadyashah नैनम ऊर्ध्वम न तिर्यम च न मध्ये परिजग्रभत दैट नो बडी कैन ग्रास्प और कैच दिस परमात्मा फ्रॉम अबव ऊर्ध्वम न तिर्यम हॉरिजॉन्टली न मध्ये इन द मिडिल यू कैंट कैच दिस परमात्मा because which is above, that itself is not known. Which is above, which is below, and which is horizontal, what is vertical, if it is a formless, then in the formless you do not know what is above and below and all that. And even it is cosmic Virat Rupa, there also Arjuna says, I do not know, okay, which is your beginning, which is your middle, which is your end, I do not know. It is said when Bhagavan Sri Krishna went to Hastinapur as a peace messenger, Duryodhana wanted to catch him. He doesn't know Nainamana Uddhavana Tiryanja. And Bhagavan in Virat Roop, and he tried to catch. Or you are going to imprison Bhagavan? But Yashodaji caught him. Yashodaji tied him also to that morta. You understand? So there it is said that this Krishna, who's above, below, right, left, nobody knows, nobody can catch him, but Yashoda caught him and tied him. Because that is power is there only in bhakti. Bhakti, such power is there. And because Bhagwan, he melts and he allows himself to be bound. Baki to koi unko band nahi sakta. Nobody can bind. But if he says, okay, I want to get bound, then it is fine. So Upanishad Artham, it is said, whom did that Yashoda tie? Is a very theme and truth of the Upanishad. That Upanishad, the truth was tied down to that mortar. Otherwise, Nainam Urduham, Natiryam Cha, Namadde Parijagarabhat, Natasya Pratima Asti. What a beautiful expression. Natasya Pratima Asti. There is no Pratima means Murti also, you know, statue, idol, form. Pratima also means comparison. People say you are idol worshipper. What idol worship? We said Natasya Pratima Asti. I am going to break your idol. Try. Natasya Pratima Asti. Pratima world is very beautiful. There is no replica. There is no one similar to it. So Pratima means Upama also. No example, no simile is there. Pratima means form also there. A statue also. Pratima has got many meanings. How anybody will make any statue of Bhagavan or idol of any Bhagavan? It is he allows anyone to do anything, that is a different matter. But otherwise, Natasya Pratima Asti, Yasya Namam Mahad Yashaha. His great name is Mahad Yashaha. Mahad Yashaha is his name. If you are looking for a new name, many people name their child as Yash. Mahad Yash. Mahad Yashaha. Great glory is his name. So as such, nobody can destroy that Pratima of Bhagavan. Who can destroy it? This is what a beautiful expression it is. Natasya Pratima Asti, Yasya Nama Mahad Yashaha. Well, whose name is great glory. So there is no comparison, no other example, no replica, nothing is there of that. This is this Paramatma. Nainam urdhvam natiryam cha namadde parijagravat natasya pratima asti yasya nam mahad yashaha yasya nam mahad yashaha. That Paramatma we believe in. Now another shlumantra. This also is familiar mantra to the Upanishad students. Nasandrishe tishtati rupamasya.
Nasandrishe tishtati rupamasya.
Nachakshusha pasyati kaschanainam.
Nachakshusha pasyati kaschanainam.
Hridaradistam manasaya enam.
Hridaradistam manasaya enam.
एवं विदुर अमृतास्ते भवन्ति। वेर इज दिस मंत्र? इफ यू आर आस्किंग मीन्स इट मस्ट बी इन सम उपनिषद। ऑलमोस्ट सेम यू नो व्हाट इज दैट कठोपनिषद न संदृशे तिष्ठति रूपमस्य न जनसे न तस्य प्रतिमा अस्ति। देर इज नो प्रतिमा नो फॉर्म रूप ऑफ दैट भगवान सो हाउ कैन इट बी देर इन योर आइज देन न संदृशे तिष्ठति रूपमस्य। द परमात्मा ट्रू नेचर कैन नॉट रिमेन इन योर आईज दैट मीन्स विद इन द रेंज ऑफ सेंस परसेप्शन इट डज नॉट फॉल within the range of sense perception. Therefore, na chakshusha pashyati kashchana enam. And therefore, no one is able to see that Paramatma. Then somebody say, but there are so many devotees of the Lord who had the vision of God. Yes. That form which people and devotees saw, yes, nobody denies that. Because the Lord who is beyond forms, he can assume any form. Right? And therefore, if someone wants to see that Lord in a particular form and worships that and meditates on that and continuously contemplates on that, then Bhagavan says, ye yathamam prapadyante, तथैव भजाम्यहम्। देन इन विच एवर फॉर्म यू वर्शिप मी फॉर व्हाट एवर पर्पज देन आई विल ब्लेस यू। दैट इज वन ऑफ द फॉर्म्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड ही शोड यू दैट फॉर्म बट डोंट थिंक भगवान इज ओनली दैट मच। द ट्रू एसेंस ऑफ दैट परमात्मा इज न संदृशे तिष्ठति रूपमस्य। इट इज योर ओन सेल्फ इन योर हार्ट। And when it is said, you one cannot see with the eyes, means cannot hear by the ear also, cannot smell by the nose, cannot taste by the tongue, cannot touch already, you know, cannot catch it, already pointed out. It is neither karmendriya vishaya, jnanandriya vishaya, mano vishaya, but hridhar hridhistham manasaya enam viduhu. But enam vidu, those people who know this atma, not as an object of the senses, but hridistham in their own heart, manasa by the mind, which mind hrida, which is absorbed in the heart, enam viduhu, then amrutaste bhavanti, they become immortal. Acha, now the question is, what is the nature of this knowledge? How do you know it then? When it cannot be seen by the sense organs, and natasya pratima asti, and there is no form and all that, how will you know that? What is the nature of that knowledge? So it is pointed out here. Generally, our knowledge is, it is this, 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 this. You ask anything about any object or any person, you know that? Yeah, I know that. Or I know this. Isn't it? This or that you call. Suppose you are traveling and your name is Mr. X. Why should I tell particular name? Mr. X. Then what happens? As you are traveling, somebody is sitting next to you and start talking to you. And that man is going to meet Mr. X only. But he does not know this is Mr. X or not. And then they're talking and all that. Do you know Mr. A? Oh, yes, of course I know it. Mr. B? Not really. But I think he is not a good man. You know, you just now you say that you don't know him and then you say, no, but Mr. C, by name only I know him, you know. So you go on asking about, then, do you know Mr. X? Just think what will be the answer. When he asks, do you know A, B, C, D? Then he says, I know, I don't know, I know very well, I know only by name. Oh yes, I know that person. But when he asks, do you know Mr. X? What he says, that is me. Isn't it? Because you can't say, I don't know him. Because he's not different from you. I can't say I know him very well or only by name and all that, nothing. But the answer is, that is me. Not that I know him or I don't know him. Here this is called the Hridistham. When you think of this Atma, it is not that it is some object about which you can say, no, don't know, but it is, that is me. This Atma Tattva is me, Hridistham. So the knowledge, the nature of this knowledge is without any division of the knower and the known. Any other knowledge that what we have, there is always with the duality of the knower and the known. But here, it is without the duality of the knower and known. It is me. It's called akhandartha. There is no khanda, there is no division. That's why it is said, hrida hridistham manasaya enam evam vidu. In this way, those who come to know that this is my own self, amrutaste bhavanti, they become immortal. Now, people scared of death. Then scared of death, where will you go if somebody is scared of death? If you go to another frightened person who is already insecure and living in fear, so he will frighten you more only. So only you have to go to that who is fearless, who is beyond death. Right? So here the next mantra says that those people who come to know this Atma Tattva, Amrutaste Bhavanti, they become immortal, they become fearless, free from the fear of death and all that. But there are other people who are living in fear, what they should do? What they should do? That is said here in the next mantra. Ajata ittevam kaschid bhiruhu prapadyate. Rudrayate dakshinam mukham.
Rudrayate dakshinam mukham.
Tenamam pahi nityam. Now, earlier it was said, those people who know this truth, amruta bhavanti, they become immortal, fearless. They are not afraid of death. Now, kaschid bhiruhu prapadyate. Now, kaschid, there is some person, bhiruhu, daravan, you know, scared. And some people have got general fear. General fear? Yeah. Like some people have got general weakness, you know. General weakness. In the sense, general fear. General fear means fear of everything. They are afraid of people, afraid of places, afraid of experiences, even what will happen. You are thinking only there, whatever. I don't know what is going to happen. And so if you don't know, then what is there? Sometime back, one lady came to me and she says, she was so worried, you know, what will happen tomorrow. I asked her, how old are you? She says, 75-year-old. So I said, how many tomorrows you have already seen? Now, you just think of a person who is 75-year-old, And every day you just getting, you, what will happen tomorrow? Our Baba, in 75 years, how many tomorrows are already gone? And you are there. Tomorrow cannot be exactly like today. Admitted. It cannot be exactly like today. But if you just go on fearing that what will happen tomorrow, even before something has happened to you. You are already living in fear for nothing. Imaginary only. So kaschit bhiruhu prapadyate. Prapadyate means seeks refuge. Refuge in Paramatma. Why he seeks refuge in Paramatma? That is only wise thing to do. Because ajata ityevam. Because he knows Bhagavan is free from birth. And therefore free from death also. So Bhagavan is free from all this time limitation. That's why he is called Mrityunjaya. Mrityunjaya. Mrityunjaya namo. Mrityunjaya Bhagavan is the conqueror of death. So ajata ityevam kaschit bhiru prapadyate. So this person says, I am frightened, but I know there is this Lord who is free from all fear. Say, hey Rudra, Rudra Bhagavan, Rudra Lord Shiva is Mrityunjaya, beyond death also. Te dakshinam mukham. Yatte dakshinamukham, that your southern face, you know, tena mam pahi nityam, by that you all the time protect me. You see, it is said, the dakshina disha, the south disha, is considered as the dwelling place of Lord Yamraj, death. Lord death. And Lord Shiva is one who faces south only. And that's why it's called Dakshinamurti Bhagavan. Dakshinamurti Bhagavan, you have the name. Dakshinamurti. Facing the south. Generally, when we make the temples and deities of other than Lord Shiva, you generally see that it must be facing east or west, north. Huh? Not but generally south. But Bhagavan Shivaji says, yes, south. So he said, O Lord, that face by which you are facing the south, you know, by that you protect me. That means you are beyond all time. You are beyond all death. So I seek refuge in you. Then you will protect me. Now see, the idea is, see, there are two entities. One is called the body and one is called the Atma. Atma is free from birth and death and all that. And the body is subject to birth and death. Now suppose I identify with my body and I understand this is what is the nature of the body is. And I accept it. Then there is no fear. If the body is subject to this, it will go. Just accept it. Just as from childhood, when you come to young age to the old age, you just accept it or not? Yeah, because after this, this has to come. So this also happens. Once you accept it, there is no fear. Or if you know that you are ajanma, avinashi, birthless, deathless, immortal self, then again there is no fear. You know why our fear is? Because we identify with the body. And we don't want to die. Because we don't want to die, because we don't want to age, and the body is subject to that, so then comes the fear. This non-acceptance of that. So therefore, a bhakta says, O Lord, I seek refuge in you. That Markandeya Rishi story is famous. He held on to that Lord Shiva then. Kim Karishyati Vai Yamaha. Then what Yamaraj will do? That is Bhakti Marga. Jnana Marga is what? this Chaitanya Atma, which is beyond all names, form, birth and growth and death, that is me, then again you are feeling. Here this in Upanishad, you know, the beautiful combination, you know, of jnana, bhakti, beautiful it goes on. So, jnana marga pointed out, those who come to know the truth, immortal they become. But suppose there is someone who is frightened, and then what you should do? Pray to Bhagavan, sharan ho jao. And that prayer continues. Again, this next mantra is known from the Rudra Suktam. Okay, earlier we have seen the Rudra Suktam. Now this is the last mantra of this fourth chapter. Manasto ketanaye mana ayushi.
Manasto ketanaye mana ayushi.
Mano goshu mano ashveshuri rishaha.
Mano goshu mano ashveshuri rishaha.
Viran mano rudra bhamito vadhihi.
Viran mano.
Havishmanta sadamitva
havamahe.
Hey Rudra Bhagavan, because you are the Samharakarta also, hey Rudra, please, please what? Ma vadhihi, do not kill, do not destroy. Oh, what? Manastoke. Naha, our toke children. Ma ririshaha ma vadhi. Ririsha means in your anger. Because we are children, we misbehave. Sometimes you get angry, you know. So don't punish us. You know? Killing to bahut dur ki baat hai, but please, please. Danda mat maar dena. Here also these parents and teachers and all that, you know, they have to control themselves so much because some students, children, they are so unruly and so disruptive and so on. You feel like, you know, one child abuse. So you cannot even scold, you cannot do anything and all that. So here also says Bhagavan, we are children, we do all gadabada, that is our prerogative. So that is, we do go on wrong things. But please, you don't get angry. See, our prayer is, you don't get angry. We may do wrong things, but we don't punish. Manas toke, don't punish our children, don't kill their children. Tanaye, tanaye means grandchildren. Oh. Mana ayushi, and please don't cut our lifespan. Bishwi ne mar jaye hum. We should live our full life, you know, whatever that. Mana ayushi, mano goshu, no means naha our goshu. Please do not kill our cows, ashveshu, and our what you call ashwamis, not elephant, horses, ririshaha. Being destruction, bring destruction, please. Do not punish, do not bring destruction to our children, our grandchildren, our lifespan, and our nowadays everybody is not having, you know, the cows and horses and all that, but they have got BMWs and Lexus and Mercedes and all that. Please see that, you know, they are. Don't meet with an accident and all that, and they remain safe. Mano ashveshuri risha, do not bring destruction. Viran mano rudra bhamito vadhihi, ibhamita in your anger. Please do not destroy our great soldiers, our heroes, our warriors, and all of them. Please don't. Havishmantas sadamitva havamahe, and always. We offer this oblation to you, offer this worship to you. See, what is in the Jnana Marga, it is already pointed out that this Paramatma is the very self of all beings, and those who come to realize that self are their own, if they own their own heart, and it is their own self, then such realized, enlightened masters, they are freed from all bondages and fear, and they attain supreme peace. That's already said. Now, there are people who suppose they cannot understand this path. Then what they say? You please seek refuge in the Lord. Mam ekam sharanam braja. Bhagavan said, yes, you surrender to me. And then I will take. Bhagavan said, yeah, gussa to aa raha tha. I was getting angry, but now what to do? You said, I am sorry. He said, okay, now. Rahati na pravuchit chuk kiye ki ekarat surat isaya bar he ki. And Bhagavan's one good nature is, if once a person goes and surrenders, he forgets whatever you have done earlier, then that is very nice thing. That way he is forgetful. Bhagavan don't. Prabhu mere avagun chitna dharo, samadarshi hai namatiharo. है ना भगवान, ये हमारे अवगुण मत चिद्धरो. वी नो दैट वी आर अवगुणीज एंड वी आर ऑल दैट एंड ऑल दैट, बट प्लीज प्लीज भगवान प्लीज. मानस तो केतन ये मान आयुषि मानो घोषु मानो अश्वेशु रीरिषः वीरान मानो रुद्र भामितो वधीहि हविष्मन्तः सदमित्वा हवामहे. एंड विद दिस एंड्स this fourth chapter. Now there are two more chapters. Now this, since there is no class in the evening today, so today we'll not have Shvetashvatara Upanishad, but tomorrow of course we'll meet. Tomorrow we'll meet and then do the fifth, begin the fifth one. Right? Now let us sing the name of the Lord. Can sing this scale also. Ram Ram Sita Rama Ram Chandra Pahima Ram 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 Sita Rama Ram Chandra Pahima. Regular. चंद्र पाहि माम राम राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि माम राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि माम कृष्ण कृष्ण गोपाल वासुदेव पाहि माम कृष्ण कृष्ण गोपाल वासुदेव पाहि माम राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि माम राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि माम हर हर गंगाधरा कंठ पाहि मां हर हर गंगाधरा नीलकंठ पाहि मां हर हर गंगाधर नीलकंठ पाहि मां राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि मां राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि मां सीता राम रामचंद्र पाहि मां राम राम सीता राम रामचंद्र पाहि मां राम कृष्ण गोविंद हरे पाहि मां हरे पाहि मां सियावर रामचंद्र की राधावर कृष्णचंद्र की उमापति महादेव की जय श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।